from picturesque village of Valsaon, Goa, India, and now currently based in New Delhi, Anthony Evaristo Braganza has made his name in music industry from yesteryears. He is one such great Goan bass guitarist who is currently in the top list. Anthony rocks when playing wonders. Mojo Borapura is Asa, the famous bass guitarist who have played all across Goa, India, everywhere. None other than Anthony Braganza. Police adhyak yo kartuka, amcha aiche he karyapulin. He is known as Anton. So what should I say? Anton, Anthony.
Yes, Anton, Anthony will do.
Alright, there he is, Mr. Anthony Braganza. Police adhyak yo kartuka, amcha aiche he karyapulin. Anton, as the world calls you in the name. New Year achi ununit polbi. Okay, new year, mujhe new start.
New start, okay. Every year.
So what are your new year resolutions?
Yeah, looking for everything, this COVID thing gets over and I'm looking forward to rock again, like, you know, for our gigs and everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Which okay. I was supposed, this year we could not go, I was supposed to go to UK and all the places, maybe.
Okay.
That's my religion.
Okay.
And do some good music also, compose some songs and let the world listen to it.
Okay, so that is his New Year resolution. Anthony Evaristo Braganza was born on 3rd of April to parents Peter and Irene Braganza. Anthony, popularly known as Anton, has a brother through whom he actually learned to play the bass. That's what he mentions. Brother's name, Ashok Braganza. After doing his schooling and passing out from Chogles College, there was never an end to music. So 27 years of experience in music, in playing for a hotel, and having completed 30 years of experience in playing as a bass guitarist makes him a number one great bass guitarist of Goa. Anthony has n number of collections of bass guitars.
Hi, these are my instruments. This is my fender pedal, this is my main pedal, this is my step pedal, this is also my bass pedal, this is my snare pedal.
I'm from a village called Valsaon. Sunset.
Okay.
Yeah. When I was young, I was in the choir singing. Maybe today I am not a singer side, but as early stage, when I was young, I was in the choir singing, doing solfège and all those stuff studies.
Okay.
But when I was 13, 14 years, in my village, I played keyboard. And when I reached a college, when I joined Chokle College. So I played for, you know, gathering all this function as a keyboard player. But at the same time, I have another friend of mine.
Okay.
His name is called Benny Pinto.
Yeah.
So we played the same day. But then the beginning of the year, we were just 15, 16 years old. We didn't know what if music will happen and if we are good or bad. At the time, one day we were performing and our friend said, "Hey, Benny, you guys should play together." So it was, so how we can play together? He's also a keyboard player, I'm also a keyboard player. Two keyboard players can't do.
Yeah.
As the time went slowly, so every time we said, "Hey, if you both play together, it'll click." Then I used to love bass. This is my subject, whatever. This is a bass.
Yeah.
This is my, so I said, I'm going to shift to bass. So it was difficult. The beginning still was difficult. People booed us.
Yeah.
People, everyone start with as a beginner, fresher. So life start with that. Nobody's good. We are just trying to play the few notes of bass and all. Maybe some places people appreciate, some people booed us, people blah, blah. But that made us strong.
Okay.
You know, that
when people do
mistakes, and when people don't like your thing, they complain about you. And those are the this. So as the time came, so we start playing together. We did some that's the
record.
Okay.
most probably how old kitle varshancha halo
so bada sa we were 15-16 zone
15-16
yeah
okay
yeah but then I joined I was doing a upright bass you know upright bass mm-hmm. I did some when I was young I did that
mm-hmm.
but that was I actually went to learn piano since mm-hmm. I was playing keyboard I went to learn piano but the in here music circle here mm-hmm. those people didn't encourage me because I don't have piano at home
mm-hmm.
the lady said it's waste you know learning piano you don't have you will not practice at home
mm-hmm.
then they asked me can you do the upright bass I used to play little bit bass also they said upright so I did about 5 grade in upright bass that's okay. in Panjim Kal Academy
mm-hmm.
With Father Ludin Barrett
mm-hmm.
but then at the age of 15-16 I gave up I joined a rock band
okay
Yeah, because rock band was excitement that time. Mm-hmm. Nobody wanted to do classic music, yeah. you know, play with a bow.
Mm-hmm.
So that era, that was, today I'm repenting because if I wish I could continue my subject, I mean, learn all the upright bass, at least mm-hmm. complete 8th grade. But then in the college days, we want to play in the band, we want to play with shows, and mm-hmm. you know, we play in the college, you know, all that. Because if you play in the rock band, pop band, or you know, everyone likes you, you're on the girls like you and everything like that. So it was that was the thing. If you play classical, no one likes
right.
you. Okay? So that was the thing. But as the time came, we did something here. And then when he went to Delhi, he called me and I joined. That's how we formed Black Sway. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Black Sway was there. We didn't have a name.
Mm-hmm.
What name to keep. But then for 1 year, there were no Black Sway. So we thought Benny and Dale decided to keep the same name,
mm-hmm.
which I'm still carrying on with them. Members are not the same. Benny also, he joined some different band. Mm-hmm. Everything. It's now today it's me alone. Mm-hmm. Black Sway means me. That's all.
Okay. Okay. Tell me from the start, which was the first band that you have performed? Like, was it Black Sway?
No.
Slate, or what was
no,
it?
No, we went to a lot of bands before in Goa.
Mm. Do you recall any? Which was the way you started?
Yeah, I was part of small band, a lot of bands. First we did me and the boy from Kansala drama.
Mm.
And when we were kids, like 15-16. We called ourselves, the name was quite weird.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody gave us, you know, because we were young boys and we were a little bit, looking a little weird, like, you know.
All okay.
So the guy called us Devil Disciples.
Okay, why Devil? Very weird.
Devil. That's what I'm saying, yeah. Because we were hardcore rock, you know, metal rock it was. That era, the rock metal.
Mm-hmm.
So they said, gave us some weird name.
Mm.
But we did for 6-4 months and then we joined some pop band. There was
okay.
no money for that, so then we joined some other band. Then I was part of the band called Soundwave.
Mm-hmm.
They were also quite popular. I played with me and Benny,
mm-hmm.
played together. Then I used to substitute a band in whenever the bass player is not there. I used to go and play. It's called Manpower.
Mm-hmm.
Days. Then I joined Lewis Revivals. That's another
okay.
band. They mm-hmm. also were they were famous band those days.
Mm-hmm.
I played with them for 1 year, more than 1 year, 2 years. Then they gave up. Then I joined another band called Ivorians.
Okay.
Yeah.
So journey.
That was last
day.
Yeah, that's the last band which I played.
Mm-hmm.
Then I had offered to go to Delhi. Then 1991 I left.
Okay.
Yeah.
So now are you stuck with Black Slate?
Yeah, Black Slate is me today. It's all me. I'm handling everything.
Okay.
I have been traveling everywhere. Whatever I do, Black Slate is with me.
Mm-hmm.
All the musicians are new guys. But some of my singers, they play with me. Sometimes whoever's free, they play.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Anthony is famous for his Delhi-based Goan band Black Slate, which is gaining a lot of popularity day by day. The way he performs at gigs and his style of playing the bass guitar sets your foot tapping. Played for jazz and various concerts at international levels in all corners of the world.
Okay, so but why so much liking for bass guitar? I just don't know. Like you have said, switch to a piano from guitar. But why?
Keep, yeah.
Why so much addiction?
Yeah, bass. Then as I came as a practicing, like you know. Beginning it was in Goa, I was nothing, I was beginner, I'm not good. And when I went to Delhi, I saw the competition, everything, like you know.
Mm-hmm.
So in 91 I went to Delhi. So that's my, you know, my full life changed, everything
mm-hmm.
changed, everything became different for us. Mm-hmm. And I never did any, this is what I did, I never worked for anything,
mm-hmm.
I never done any other work. I just, throughout my life, I just played bass only.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And that
okay.
made me rocking. And every day I play, now in the club, wherever I played big shows, if I like sometimes we play for show like 20,000 people or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And I sometimes I play because we many me and Benny we were our showmanship was you know completely out of world. Mm. I think so something and even here still today it's been 30 years now we're doing the same thing, but when we play. When put the guitar and be on the stage, it's something different.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe a lot of bands play opposite us, but we'll do, it's like we perform for maybe half an hour, whatever.
With,
and in the end, you'll see at least, you know, 25%, maybe not 20, at least 5-10% people will come to look out for us, to meet us, to take autograph, sign that time, you know, that was era. So we were like completely different. That now today we have become old a little bit, but that era we had long hair. We were
never mind, old
But that era we were hardcore, professionally involved in everything. We were serious in everything. We had a mindset, you know, mindset. We focus on when we went there. We said what we this will do. We were not doing any other work. We were not doing any full day and music.
Mm-hmm.
We get up. First thing we practice a song. Then we were performing in a hotel.
Mm-hmm.
So straight away, hotel practice, eat the food there also, drink everything, sleep there, get up again, practice.
So I can say you're born for music.
Yeah. So we were stuck and then, we had a you know, dream to do and we want to be the best of the best.
Mm-hmm.
And when we went to Delhi, we were nowhere.
Okay.
We got lost. All the bands were here. We were here only.
Mm-hmm.
So it was a challenge and it's a mindset. So if we have to come together, then people were said, you, that time, that era, I went to play there, but it's a difficult time staying. Winter was very extreme cold, summers.
Mm.
So if you have to come to Goa, they will say, what happened? You can't play or what? They throw you out of something.
Mm.
So we took a challenge, stick to whatever the, you know, the problem or situation is that. So then we said, okay, let's do whatever. We didn't have anything.
Mm-hmm.
So then we talked, not only music. Then I said, I need to have my own house. We need to have best cars or best. But playing bass, I got everything.
Okay.
Anthony and Benny shared a good space when on stage. Their showmanship and their long hair with the musical notes set the stage on fire. The saddest part that we cannot get to see them playing together as they now belong to two different bands. Wherein Anthony continues with his band Black Slates.
So that was sticking to music, but Jenna hai mutta ki, did you have a family support when you especially start your career with music? There's a lot of problems.
You know what as my parents supported me when I was young till I was 21 years old.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
My dad when 16, 17 we went to you know we played, my dad got me guitar whatever I want he gave me.
Mm-hmm.
But once I become 21, 22 years they didn't support me. They mlari baba kit kota hai kela ye band aila
hai jatle
goye kidata lo kalduka. So then say you know band aila then you drink you are babze jatlo and yes cup kitalo sar kitalo. So that is a bit but we focus we were opposite.
Mm-hmm.
We were involved such a way, we took music very serious.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't go to the other vices, okay, getting drunk and spoiling the function. We stick to that. We were, we used to, whatever we have time, we went to martial art, karate, workout, you know, had some work, some other professional.
Mm-hmm.
So we are busy with other professionals also, playing football, some sports and something.
Mm-hmm.
So that made us not to drink much. So sometimes we want to drink. Now we drink because as a cross in age, there's no problem. But that era we were not drinking. We were completely, my boys, those days, we were completely different band. We were very focused. We were very serious. Our dream was to play everywhere.
That is why we've reached such a high level.
Yeah. So when you get a team such a way, everyone's together, all the fingers together, you can rock the world. But everything is not together, so you go up and down, everything, because your idea is different, my idea is different.
Mm-hmm.
But those days, we were all together. We did whatever we want. But today, everyone a different way, because some of them become old, they don't want to play, they don't want to travel. That's the problem today.
Mm-hmm.
Because early morning, we have to go, and our gigs goes on sometimes 3-4 hours.
Mm-hmm.
When you play embassies and all in Delhi, we start at 8 o'clock and then go on till 3 in the morning also.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So some people they can't do. So they said, "Baba, I don't want to play." Then it becomes a problem. as the time came. Then other guys went somewhere, he focused on, he joined some other band.
This dashing personality has worked as a choreographer, dancer, a model, a brand ambassador for many of the ads when he was young, and now is a former musician at Jago State President Goa. He is one such musician that has brought new life to the music. That too, pulling the crowd with his bass guitar, that's mind-blowing.
Okay, tell me something about your family then. Okay.
My family.
Are you married, first of all?
I'm married, but like, you know, not like proper marriage. Mm-hmm. I have girlfriend, whatever, but not not a proper marriage.
Okay, then not to disclose. Yeah. Right. Okay, how many brothers are you in the family? Are you single?
We are two brothers.
Two.
Yeah.
Okay.
So my brother also, actually, he started learning first. Mm-hmm. He was learning. I never went to school of music, nothing.
Mm-hmm.
I was watching him and I started playing.
Okay.
Like that.
So that was a wonderful learning because this is something new. Yeah, looking at the other.
Yeah,
and the other.
Yeah, he used to go to learn from Father Peter from Pilar.
Mm-hmm.
So he used to come and I said, "See what he taught you." Then he said, "This like this." So I picked up. I don't know how I pick up. It's accidentally I begin. No, but my dad and they were earlier. No, my family. Music was compulsory in the Portuguese era. The music was compulsory.
Mm-hmm.
They were first to fifth standard. Everyone is to learn blowing instrument, some instrument they used to learn violin. Hmm. Most of the people are violin, but they didn't take it serious. It was just how you take part, like, you know, you have subjects in a school, maths, drawing, everything. So that music also just this. So we had the subject like that. And my village in Welsam, we are traditional, you know, like a Portuguese call, like a proper this. So everyone was singing, choir, church, every Sunday we had to compulsory go to church. And holidays we... every day we have to be in church, morning get up, go to church, practice, sing, do the thing. It's like that. So in earlier stage of beginning of Blackstreet, me, then other guy, Norman, we used to sing, we were choir band.
Okay.
When we were, you know, 14, 15 years old, we used to sing, someone is getting married, we used to play for a choir.
Okay.
So, but we had a dream, okay, one day we'll also play for wedding, the big shows. So, it's like that. So, life, yeah. But everything is possible. It's, you need to focus your mindset. It's called a mindset.
Mm-hmm.
You focus on this thing. I want to do this. I want to do. Okay. If you put everything, you want to do this. Too many things. No, you can't.
Okay. So since it has been how many years like that you are in music like till now?
Yeah, about 32-33 years.
My God, but, you've lost silver jubilee.
Yeah, so 29 years I'm in Delhi now.
Okay, 29. This,
yeah, next year I'm going to be...
But did you feel like, Janatu Delhi settle, when you were in Delhi, like, Janatu ek move get lo, did you miss Goa?
Yeah, beginning, yes. That's why every May, we came to Goa to perform.
Every May?
Yeah, we took 45 days. We were hotel band. We played in hotel. Every day we played. We never had a break. Sometimes shows, this and that, traveling every day. But month of May, end of mid-April till May, we used to come to Goa, 45 days break, and we used to play everywhere in Goa.
Okay.
Sometimes in a month, 45 shows, like sometimes 3 shows per day.
Mm-hmm. Okay. In
those, that, today is not, Goa is not the same.
Yeah.
But that era, we used to play somewhere in the, like, Kolwa Beach, Bonanza. After that, we used to go and play Kalangur, and we used to play for a bit show.
Yeah.
Then we used to come and play Kuturi, and there's a dance, something. In the early morning at 5 o'clock, we used to come and play for a dance. So
since you have mentioned that Benny and you were like good...
Benny, Norman also.
So, all do like, you miss these beach shows which were going on?
Yeah, of course. Then? That is my... Even now also, I encourage people to do beach show like Salzora and all the places. But then... the situation is such a, it became like Goans are not united. The Goans are, you know, complaining. The beach show, when one fellow is doing, other guy will complain to the cops.
Right.
And suddenly the cops will come, they'll stop the show. Mm-hmm. Somebody is, you know, Goans are not united in Goa.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you call. But today, I prefer, we play in Northeast now. It's called, you know, like what was happening in Goa all these years, like 30 years back, 20 years back. We used to have, you know, Alem beer, Alem festival. We used to play, we had 30,000-40,000 people. But same culture now, if you go to Guwahati, it's happening there. If you go to Shillong, it's rocking. You go to all this Manipur, Mizoram, all these places, it's rocking. But Goa is what happened. The Goans are left Goa. No? So most right. of, we have already 20% of Goans are left.
Mm-hmm.
So what, they don't have a culture. So it's dying day by day.
Mm.
I'm still fighting for it to, you know, do beach shows whenever. We are not a wedding band. We don't do weddings much
mm-hmm.
or, you know, playing in a restaurants like mm-hmm. that much. We were focused on corporate shows. That's what we did. First, when I was in Goa, we used to play for weddings and all. But now also we played a few weddings, which, mm. you know, someone very high, special one, who mm. gives up flight tickets up and it costs them, who mm. can afford to pay, or maybe. But even now, these days, I have a lot of people are forcing me to play for weddings since mm. I'm in Goa these days. But which I didn't do that. I was not. We were more of a concert band, you know,
mm-hmm.
like excitement. People go, when we play, people go, you know, like, people don't dance, they only watch you, like, so that is what we like, you know. We used to have, we used to go wild, like, reaction, showmanship, everything was there.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay. So, going ahead with the interview, tell me something. Who was your, like, the idol, like, for you to follow footsteps for in your music career? Like,
my idol was, you know, I won't believe, my neighbor. When I was young boy, 6-7 years, I used to go to, he used to take me for, you know, what he called the church.
Mm, okay.
He was elder to me, little, at least 5-8 years elder mm. to me. He used to take me to church, he used to sing, play guitar and
okay.
And every day he used to play loud music, practice.
Mm-hmm.
And that fellow today is my inspiration, whatever it is. His name is Dr. Elvin Barreto.
Okay.
And today he's one of the best doctors in India today.
Yeah.
He's skin surgeries, whatever, no, mm-hmm. heart special, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And he's a dean for so many hospitals in Manipur. Now he's in Chennai, I think so.
Mm-hmm.
But that, he was my inspiration. He used to sing, he used to play. But then his brother also, he was a singer in a band called Hard Rock or something, Tony.
Mm-hmm.
So we were very young. So okay. we go and see
since when day. You said that since you were 21, like your mother, like they were after you, like it got all over.
Yeah, then they said no. They were very
now
upset.
Now do they feel pride of themselves that you have reached a certain level? Like
yeah, then when I had all the best, when I got my own stuff, I got my car, everything. Then they realized, okay, I can stand on my own feet.
Mm-hmm.
But then it was a became. Then I used to go travel wherever I want to go. I come to Goa whenever they want me. Mm-hmm. Every month I used to come to Goa.
As a great guitarist, Anthony has a lot of travel history.
Earlier 90s, we are the first band to play most of the states in North India.
Mm-hmm.
Like Jaipur, they never seen we were the first band to play a big concert and like a mad guy, you know, sari, long hair, some weird guys. We played Lucknow, nobody knows who are these guys. Like they used to have small bands, wedding band, restaurant
mm-hmm.
band,
mm-hmm.
but big concert, we were the main band.
Mm-hmm.
Chandigarh, Punjab and all people saw that we were the, like a, you know, like a real band, big band, 20,000, 30,000 people, mm-hmm. like 60,000 people came for all our shows.
Okay.
Yeah, so we were the, in Delhi, we were the main inspiration for a lot of people today. And all the bands, even I stay in the same place or whatever it is, all the musicians, 20 of the musicians who are big star today,
mm-hmm.
they all came to us.
Okay.
They learned from us. We made them a star today.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
They're big guys like KK, you heard mm-hmm. of KK, Yaro,
yeah.
Pearl.
Mm-hmm.
He used to sit with us.
Okay.
Then this other guy called Sufi singer.
Mm-hmm.
One guy came to Ari. Sir, can we do this music? It's called Sufi. I said, what Sufi? Hindi. He said, let's do this. I said, come, let me learn also. So I'll at least let me get the idea of Hindi.
Mm.
So we did for 4 years. Now he's a superstar. He charges 15 lakhs per day.
Oh my God.
His name is Kailash Kher.
Okay.
You know, he's a big guy like all this.
Mm.
Lot of guys. Another girl, Mohini, she used to come to Goa, Bombay, wherever there. She used to hang around with us. Today she sang that Senorita song.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tarada mm-hmm. Senorita, mm-hmm. that's those song.
Mm-hmm.
Then Annamika, we played with Annamika also. She's a big star.
Okay.
Then Shibani Kashyap. You name more than 20 years, Rabbi Saigal, whoever, they used to come every day at my place.
Okay.
Drink Goan Fini, Keju Fini, Urat, sausages, whatever they had, they had everything. The okay. Hindu also, they sausage, but so high time.
He has made his contribution and has been of great help to many of well-known singers and artists.
We play pop rock also,
mm-hmm.
but we were focusing mostly, we were known as more of a, like a rock band.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So that era was a little, we have some old rock song which we Goans didn't like.
Mm-hmm.
Goa was not a, for, you know, people didn't like rock much. But since we were hotel band, we were doing everything.
Mm-hmm.
So rock, pop, there's no, every, as long as it's music, we did everything.
Okay.
Yeah. So we did that also. Plus I represent 3 years, I played for International Jazz Festival also.
Okay.
With the foreign bands, nice. All this. And next day I was surprised to see myself. We were the best band this year and we were on the headline on the newspaper mm-hmm. in Delhi.
Mm-hmm.
So that is my big achievement, whatever. I'm mm-hmm. proud of that. Those okay. other things. But then now I have Konkani song which I have to release.
Okay.
Which I'm going to, because when I came to this, it's the first time I got a break, and mm-hmm. Since I came here,
mm-hmm.
and a lot of people, you know, theatres, you know, some guys booked me for UK, Canada also. Now mm-hmm. They want Konkani songs, everything.
Okay.
So I'm doing my Konkani songs now. With, okay. I'm not doing a sing because I don't have that voice, like, you know. So I'm using some help of my friends. They are going to sing for me.
So you have but composed?
I'm doing a composing music.
Okay. Can you just like give us like a demo or show us our audience some demo kind of a thing? Because they'll be waiting.
But the thing, I can do that way. But I can compose on the spot also, whatever title if you can be.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You know, if I'm just here. Compose a song for you, okay?
All right. Okay. No problem.
Okay. That's few words.
That will be good.
Just for a few words, okay?
Okay.
This is on the spot, okay? Mm-hmm. I don't know, maybe because I'll just say, okay, I'll say this, like, what title should I do? Okay, I got it, okay, I'll say. Okay, it's like, okay, so, down I love, myongo tuka. Yes, I'll do that. Right. Rest I'll complete.
That is so nice.
this is a live performance
which we get to see over here.
This is like how we write a song, compose. The chorus is very important.
Mm-hmm.
So we write the chorus and now the verse, other words will come. This is I'll go write today.
Mm-hmm.
This is a chorus. The chorus, like whatever I said, down, I'll do that. I'll do that.
Okay.
So based on that, I will rest, will write. Now this will become a chorus, you can say. It goes on. Now the verse I'll write. I'll sit with someone, get the ideas, and then.
Okay,
say,
you're very spontaneous.
Then. No, it's like
so experience, right? Yeah. All right.
And then mostly we play, but today we do a lot of skill music, like, you know, technique. Like this one. Mm-hmm. There's like all this.
Mm-hmm.
Like. This is the technique. Today we are more of technique, like
all right.
This, like this one. Like all this, whatever you do.
Mm-hmm.
And at the same time, when it comes to jazz and all, this are skill. So this is the skill which we do, solos and all. Mm-hmm. Then that's how the people from Northeast and real musicians, they get impressed when we play the bass like
so
this.
So as the audience must have got
impressed. Yeah, so we do whatever, like, you know, we get the audience moving. According to the feel, according to the, we move.
Mm-hmm.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight.
Moving ahead, since you have so much experience in this music, you are so freely operating the instruments and all that stuff, and you have got so many years of experience.
Yeah, it's today is like a toy for us.
Yeah.
Like, we don't have to take tension. Sometimes nowadays I do, my work is to, you know, back up some musicians.
Mm-hmm.
The old artists, Indian artists, we back them up for all the big shows.
Mm-hmm.
So the work is like, we have to do, they give you one day before, you know, they say, this 100 song we have to do.
Mm-hmm.
My future plan. I'm just chilling out. I want to play as long as I can do. Just like, you know, we were like a more like rock stars, whatever, like, you know, live performance. Just like that. That's what I want to do.
Okay. Okay. Mm-hmm. What do you see the state of Goa? Is the music industry blooming?
No. Goa has become so sad. You know, won't believe it. I see the only place which it hurts me so much nowadays also. Everywhere is rocking musically.
Mm-hmm.
And Goa was, you know, in early 90s, 20s, music was in Goa.
Mm-hmm.
We are natural born musicians. We don't have to see eye today. When I was in the, when we were young, I was in the choir, playing church also, not learn much, little bit played. Whatever we can, we have natural in Naha, because we went to a church choir, and maybe the, there are two, even Christians also go to church. Then the Hindu people, they're in all temples, singing all that. So we have both, you know, together. But the thing is, sad story is today, there's no concern, nobody's supporting. They are bringing all the outsiders,
right,
all people who had influence, all the hotels, you see, all the bands are coming from outside. They are doing Hindi music, they are putting them, they are bringing their own people.
But why does this happen, do you think?
Because greedy, all the politicians greedy, all the people, hotelers are greedy. Because they get commission, you get nothing. Because if the Goan band play, what, they'll get nothing. If the bands are coming outside, they'll get 50 from their side, they are charging 3 lakhs. 1 lakh 50 they'll keep, the only lakh they'll give them.
Right.
If a Goan band, how they can pay? That at least they can cheat, no? The client will say, I'm bringing a band from outside, it'll cost you 3 lakhs. And then they'll say these Goan bands are not this good and that.
How has that to be changed, you think so?
Because if we were strong, if someone had put a thing, no outside band, no something.
Right.
If someone have take, because our politicians, our people who are here, they are not bothered. Tell, say, makkita polter baba, makkita polter, tu chakka nahi, makkita polan. I spoke to a lot of politicians. They asked me, they said, atyan, am kita polter thi. This is what they told me.
All right. Okay. Anyways, let's go ahead and your last message for the viewers who are watching you today.
What is this like? You know, it's like mindset. If you want to focus on something, you want to do this, this is everything in your hand. I want to do this, I want to play this, I want to become this one. Now it's like I want to buy a car, you can buy a car. But you need to have, you know, that dream to achieve. That is the thing. So, and at the same time, it's a mindset. If you don't have a mindset, if you don't, you're just doing it. Like a lot of Goan people, they say, oh, what, I have this work and that. It's like a hobby for them. They are not, you know, focusing on this. They just come, they do some other work, and next day they play in the band. For last 20 years, they are playing the same song. They're playing the wedding, same song. There's no achievement. They can't on the world. And at the same time, today's music also, a lot of guys in Goa are very happy. I don't want them, like, you know, that's why I don't want to be much in Goa also, because it's like a frog in the well. They are here only. They are not. You have to do good music. You skill music, you have to go out of the box.
Right.
You don't have to be here only. And when you go out, if you play in like Calcutta, here, maybe Bangalore, Northeast, you know, Guwahati. You need really have to be skilled musician. That one band, what they played, I'm not criticizing them, they are good. But most of them, what here, sometimes they can do everything in the hand. They are lazy, they put a minus one track. They play, sometimes I hear the bass player also playing, you know, pretend that the bass solo also track is playing.
Okay.
At least solo you play something and show, not that track is playing and pretend that that is not good. That
originality.
It's like I have this one. The mindset is, you know, crucial. That's, you need to have mindset. A successful musician's mindset, you know, mindset, if you don't have, then it's useless. So, I'll tell you about mindset. This is my opinion. I just put the point.
No problem.
This is my opinion. So, I didn't have much time to play But I made time. I didn't have time, you know. But I might, you know, practice whatever. I made time to play all my music. And the second point was I didn't have the knowledge of music, whatever. But I played what I knew and sought out that and to learn more. You know, I didn't have much knowledge before. But, I learned myself and start learning. Learning is never ending. For music, it is to be a musician, you know, to be a good musician, whatever, it's like one should be never ending.
Mm-hmm.
For if you become a waiter somewhere, tomorrow you can become a captain.
Mm.
Then you can become a manager. Then after you can become GM, general manager somewhere. Yeah, that's never ending. As you grow older and older, it is learning, you know, whatever. Maybe even 50, 60, 70, doesn't. It's never ending. The third point was I didn't have anyone to support me, you know. Mm-hmm. Nobody's there to support me before or to encourage me. But I learned to support and encourage myself.
Mm-hmm.
This is my opinion.
Okay.
So the fourth point, just 4-5 points I read. Then I didn't have the confidence before.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But the confidence came to more I play. The more I play, I get confident, and the more I learn.
Okay.
You know, it's like that. This is life. This is my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
And then I had got, I had got lots of going against me. Whatever I do, it goes against me, you know. Going wrong. A lot of things are going wrong. Mm-hmm. What to do? I can't carry something. But what I did, but I concentrated, you know, I concentrated on my work, whatever I do, what I had for me. Okay. It was something was not going well, but I managed to,
mm-hmm.
you know, get over all this problem, whatever I was saying.
Okay.
Yeah. And the last one, which I had plenty of excuse, you know, before. When I was young, I had a lot of excuse. This is not, my guitar is not good. That's why I can't play good.
Mm-hmm.
You know, some other excuse, you know, I am not getting it. But what I did, I had not plenty of excuse, but why music could not work, you know, why music could not work out for me. Okay, that's like that. But I choose not to use the excuse, okay, all this, any of the excuse.
Mm-hmm.
I focus on, no, this is not wrong, daughter. I said, no.
Mm-hmm.
I fought for it.
Okay.
Yes, that is the thing. Want to achieve whatever is for anyone, viewers, whoever, who are youngsters, this is not for the young, whoever want to have a, make a career in music, to want to achieve your dream, that is the thing. The choice is theirs.
Okay, thank you. That was so lovely.
Yeah.
Straight from the heart.
Yeah,
that was written by Anton.
Thank you so much.
All right, thank you so much for giving your precious
bye-bye.
Time.
Thank you so much.
And thank you for giving us this opportunity to share your views, to bring your views towards the camera, towards the audience who are watching you today.
Yeah, looking forward to see you again, all the thing. Okay,
thank you so much. And all the best for your future endeavors.
Yeah.
That was Anton, Anthony Braganza, for you. And till then, keep watching Go On Music Vibrant. Goodbye. Do you 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 do